I'm really excited to be here and play my songs for you guys. I'm sorry if I sound a little off. I have a tiny cold that I'm getting off, so I'll try my best. For my first song for today, I'll be playing Free Fallin' by Tom Petty. I hope you enjoy. Next song, I'll be playing Sometimes Love Just Ain't Enough by Patti Smyth. Thank you. By my 12 jars ain't enough. And there's no way home when it's late at night and you're all alone. Are there things that you wanted to say? Do you feel me beside you in your bed? There beside you, where I used to lay. Somebody too much, and it's sad when you know it's your heart they can't touch. There's a reason why people don't stay who they are, 'cause baby, sometimes love just ain't enough. Baby, sometimes love, it just ain't enough. Alright, for my final song for the evening, I will be playing Everything I Do by Bryan Adams. Thank you. When you find me there, you'll search no more. Don't tell me it's not worth trying for. You can't tell me it's not worth dying for. You know it's true. Everything I do it for you. There's nothing left to hide. Take me as I am. Take my life. I would give it all. I would sacrifice. Don't tell me it's not worth fighting for. I can't help it. There's nothing I want more. You know it's true. Everything I do, oh, I do it for you. Ooh. Thank you.
Welcome back, and we're here with Laura Lederer, who just gave us the performance of her life. You said that you had a cold and you would try your best. I think you gave more than your best. I think you gave, like, you know, the world.
Thank you.
So how old are you?
I'm 11 right now.
Just 11?
Yeah, 11.
You were singing some really hardcore songs.
Thank you.
Who inspires you?
Madonna and Cyndi Lauper.
Really? And how did you learn about Madonna and Cyndi Lauper?
My parents.
Really? They let you listen to Madonna?
Yeah, I listen to the 80s channel a lot.
Really? You have cool parents. My parents won't let me listen to Madonna, I don't think, even at this point in my life. So what grade are you in?
I'm in sixth grade.
Sixth grade? So what's that, middle school?
Yeah.
Okay. So you're doing big things. And how long have you been playing the guitar?
Since I was about 6 years old.
6 years old, so that's quite some time.
Yeah.
How did you know you wanted to play the guitar?
I just started listening to songs on the radio and I really liked them, and the guitar really stood out for me. Mm-hmm. So I got one for my birthday and I started taking music lessons.
Okay, and besides playing songs from Tom Petty, do you write your own music?
Not yet. I might do that. But not yet. I'm just copying songs.
Okay. And what kind of songs do you lean towards when you're performing?
Really? I mostly do songs from the 80s around there, but I do some songs from the 2000s.
Okay, let's say if I know my 2000s, like, give me two songs. Which songs?
Well, I did some songs from the performer Roxette.
Okay. Okay, cool. I think I know who they are and how they get down. And talking about getting down, not only do you sing, you perform. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
And where do you perform?
I perform at Cultural Arts Playhouse in Syosset.
Okay. And is that the same, like, what you're doing now with your guitar, or is it a different type of performance?
It's different. I do musicals there. I sing and perform. And I've been doing that for almost as long as I played the guitar.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
And do you have a preference over which one you like to do more?
Oh, no. I love both of them. I could never choose between any of them over one another.
Okay. So how does your musical theater help with your guitar playing, or how does your guitar playing help with your musical theater?
Well, they both help each other, because my singing and my guitar playing helps my performing.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, they both help each other.
Okay. And so, if you could do any performance of any song anywhere in the world, where would it be?
It would probably be in a large stadium somewhere, mm-hmm. big, nice big place with a lot of audiences.
Okay.
A lot of big crowds.
Uh-huh.
And giant stadium, probably Madison Square Garden.
Madison Square Garden?
Yeah.
I think you're going to get there.
Thank you.
Well, I'm glad you came on the show. I think our audience is glad that you came on the show. Will you come back?
Yeah, definitely.
You won't forget me?
No, I won't.
You won't forget us?
No, I won't.
Well, thank you. And guys, there you have it. Laura Lederer here on The Brick Wall. We're finding stars, young, old. So make sure you sign an email to let us know what you think. Follow us on Twitter. And we'll see you next time.